Hi there. I'm going to show how you can leverage the Konnect platform to manage your API ecosystem from a single, easy-to-use interface. We'll run through how to use Konnect Runtime Manager to set up your own Kong API Gateway instance in Docker. Then we'll walk through how you can expose, secure, and manage your first service using the Konnect ServiceHub. Lastly, we'll publish that API to our developer portal and show how you can share that documentation with your users and developers, all within Konnect. And with that, let's get started. So when you first log into Konnect, the first thing you'll see is the Service Hub. This is where you'll add and manage your services. But before we create a service, let's create a gateway runtime, which we can use to proxy traffic to our service implementation. To do this, let's switch to the Runtime Manager, which you can find on the left-hand navigation. The Runtime Manager is where you can create and manage your gateway runtimes. Each runtime corresponds to a Kong API gateway running out within your infrastructure. These gateways can be deployed in nearly any environment. So whether you are running in your own data center, in the cloud, VMs, containers, or even Kubernetes, each runtime can be managed and configured right here in Konnect. To create a runtime, simply click the Configure Runtime button at the top right of the screen. From here, simply copy the Quick Start script and paste this into a terminal to create a new gateway instance running in Docker. While the Quick Start script here uses Docker for convenience, you can also use the Advanced option if you end up needing to deploy a gateway in a different type of environment. And here you can see at the Runtime Manager, we have a new Kong Konnect instance seen just now. Now that we have the API gateway deployed and running, let's create our first service. To create a service, use the blue Add New Service button at the top right of the Service Hub screen. This will prompt you for the service name, service version, and an optional description that other developers will see when accessing Konnect. With this service created, you can then configure an implementation for this service version. An implementation is simply the upstream URL that will be proxied to by any gateway runtime that you have deployed. So API requests go to the gateway, and then the gateway proxies those requests to the upstream implementation defined here. Once you set the URL, you can then configure a route. A route simply tells the gateway which requests should go to which upstream service. In this case, I'm going to tell the gateway that anything under the accounts path should be directed to this service. With the implementation and route defined, the service is now exposed to the gateway and is ready to receive API requests. With our service now defined and exposed, we can apply a plugin that will protect this service from accidental or malicious overuse. To do this, we're going to be using the rate limiting plugin. Rate limiting lets you restrict how often each user can call your API. To create this plugin, use the New Plugin button towards the bottom of the service version overview. From the plugin listing, you can then filter for rate limiting and then click Enable to configure this plugin. In this case, I want to apply a rate limit of 10 requests per minute. I want to apply the local policy. Once the configuration is set, click Create to activate the plugin and start rate limiting traffic. With the rate limit in place, I can use the vitals data to see 429 errors are now starting to be returned to client, showing that the rate limit is in effect and that our API is safe from someone accidentally sending too many requests. Now that our service is protected, let's show how we can improve our service performance with proxy caching. With caching, responses from our upstream service are stored by the gateway. So when the same client requests the same data, the response can be served directly from the cache. This ensures that our upstream service does not get bogged down with unnecessary, repeated requests. To enable caching for a service, use the New Plugin button at the bottom of the service version overview. From the plugin listing, filter for caching, and then click Enable on the Proxy Caching plugin to open the configuration. For this use case, we're just going to be using the default configuration with the memory strategy. With the configuration set, click Create to activate and enable this plugin. Now that we've protected our service from overuse and added a layer of caching, let's walk through how we can secure our service with key authentication. By adding key authentication, we are controlling the data that is allowed to be transmitted from our gateways and identifying unique consumers that are accessing the API. To do this, first we'll enable the key authentication plugin for our service and then create a consumer that we can use for authenticating with. To start, let's enable the plugin. To do this, use the New Plugin button at the bottom of the Service Version Overview. From the plugin listing, filter for key authentication, and then click Enable, and then Create to activate this plugin for this service. Now that the plugin is activated, any request that does not include a valid API key will automatically be rejected with an HTTP 401. To show this, let's move over to our terminal and issue a request to this service with the plugin now activated. If I issue a request to my accounts service, you can see I now get an error stating no API key found in this request. To access our API with key authentication enabled, let's create an API consumer that we can use. Consumers can be found under the Shared Config option at the bottom of the left-hand navigation. From here, click Consumers, and then New Consumer. From here, you can provide a username or custom ID to identify this consumer. And then click Create to create them. With the consumer created, you can click on the consumer and then access their credentials from the Credentials tab. From here, we'll create a new key auth credential and then click Create to have one auto-generated for us. I can then copy this key. With the key copied, I can add it to my request by either inserting it into the header under the API key field or adding it as a query parameter. With the header set, I'll issue the same request. Now, with the valid key included in the request, we can successfully authenticate with the gateway. Now that our service is exposed and ready to use, we can add it to the Konnect Developer Portal. A developer portal provides a single source of truth for your developers to locate, access, and consume services. To start, let's publish our service in the developer portal. To do this, click on the service from within the Service Hub, and then use the Publish to Portal option under the Actions drop-down at the top right. With the service published, navigate to the Dev Portal section in the left-hand navigation. From here, you can see any services that are currently published, as well as customize the appearance of the developer portal. From the dev portal itself, users can see which services are available, view auto-generated documentation for each service, and even send requests right here from the browser. So once you're ready, you can then send out a link to the dev portal and start onboarding your users. We've shown how you can leverage the power of Konnect to deploy, configure, and publish your APIs, all from a single, easy-to-use interface. By taking the burden off of your developers, you can have them focus on what really matters, building the functionality that powers your business. And we're just getting started. For more information, visit konghq.com.